Did you know more than 70% of renters own a pet? Pretty surprising, right? And the American Pet Products Association reports that 68% of all U.S. households own a pet, equating to 89 million dogs and 94 million cats. That's a lot of furry friends and pet owners that need a roof over their head. And as a landlord, you may be trying to decide whether or not you will allow pets in your rental property. At The Listing Real Estate Management, we specialize in the management of single family homes, townhomes, condos, multifamily apartment buildings throughout Central Florida and the Tampa Bay market. And as your boutique property manager, renter owners and landlords frequently ask me, should I allow pets? And the short answer, absolutely yes. But let's look at the reasons why you should allow pets in your rental property. Now, the most obvious benefit to having a pet-friendly property is that it widens the pool of prospective residents for your home. Because remember, more than 70% of renters own a pet. By not allowing pets, you drastically reduce your prospective tenant pool, which results in a longer vacancy and more out-of-pocket carrying costs for you. Many tenants have or may want a pet in the future, and by allowing pets, you will increase your resident retention due to higher renter satisfaction. And I mean, who doesn't want to see this little furry guy happy? But maybe if you're a rental owner and landlord that just doesn't want to see that pet happy, and you don't want that pet in your home,
no
or
way.
You're concerned that that pet might damage your home, tear up the carpet, pee and poop all over the house, I mean, a little 10-pound terrier is harmless, right? This little guy couldn't possibly cause any damage, but let me tell you, that little terrier may just be a Tasmanian devil.
Mary?
Huh?
What kind of dog is Puffy?
Border Terrier!
Border Terrier! Like, Benji!
Oh. Hey, hey, are you the little guy making all that big noise, huh?
And a neglected, untrained pet most definitely can cause damage to your property. As a landlord, it is completely legal and within your rights as a property owner to discriminate against pets. But what we hear at The Listing Real Estate Management advise our clients when it comes to allowing pets, and what we do when a new property goes on the rental market, is that we advertise that property as pets are negotiable and allowed on a case-by-case basis. By listing your property this way, we solve one of two problems. The first, it encourages prospective applicants to disclose if they do have any pets instead of them trying to hide them. Then based on the owner's preference on whether they'll be allowing pets, we can automatically notify the applicant that the owner does not allow pets for this property. Second, by listing as a negotiable, it avoids eliminating an excellent tenant that does care for their pet, has excellent tenant history, and owns a pet that is suitable and right for your property. And how do we determine it is a suitable pet for your home? And it's through our pet screening application process. We want to keep your investment property in great condition. Our applicants must complete a comprehensive pet screening process where we gather information such as breed or species, gender, neutered or spayed, weight, color, age, vaccination records, microchip information, verify pet behavior, along with positive previous landlord references. And that is just the short list of what we require. The purpose of the process is to ensure we get the full picture of the pet. We do not allow or approve restricted breeds that conflict with insurance policy providers. We are committed to placing the highest quality resident and pet in your home. Not to mention, it is a nice little treat to produce an additional income for allowing pets in your home. For example, our clients and rental owners get an additional monthly pet rent per pet authorized by you. On a consistent basis, because let me tell you, there's nothing worse than having to kick out an unapproved dog and having to renegotiate the terms of his leash. No pun intended. To recap the benefits of allowing pets in your rental property, One creates a larger pool of prospective tenants for your property. Two, a greater renter satisfaction and increased tenant retention over time by allowing pets. Additional income stream for a monthly pet rent or add-on services for pet amenities. Also, quality tenants expect to pay more in rent for pet-related amenities or services. For example, a large backyard for a single-family home for the dogs to run around, or a community with a pet spa and dog run are going to be things that tenants want to see. Having a pet-friendly home just makes sense. Against the considerations of possible potential noise problems or complaints or damage beyond normal wear and tear that is traditionally claimed against a security deposit, the benefits to allowing pets in a rental property far outweigh the potential risks. But avoid all the hesitation of allowing pets in your rental property by hiring the listing real estate management as your boutique property manager. If you have any questions or would like some additional information on our services, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. We'd love to be a resource for you and your real estate investment. Don't forget to like and subscribe today. Thanks for tuning in. Take it easy out there. Cheers.